that's definitely one of my bigger questions, you know, to ask everybody. What would you do, you know, if you had your hopes and dreams come true? You know, let's...
That's what we're here to do, to make them come true.
Let's get it all out on the table. Let the world hear what's up. You know, let other people, you know, try and get in on it. Let's circulate. Let's unity. You know, I say let's unity, but let's have unity.
Unify.
Let's unify. Yeah.
Yeah, this city here in Richmond, and whatever city you're in, if you're listening out of state, out of country, too, I know some of our friends on here come from other countries. Some of y'all on my page live out of state. Some of y'all live in Europe. I have a couple of y'all in England, France, Belgium. But it's the same thing. Do it out there, too. What you do for another, you do for yourself. Let me just do a time check.
Yeah.
Make sure we had a little error with our video going a couple of seconds over.
Well, I wrote on my
Facebook with Jerry. We got 12, 10 minutes.
I wrote on my board, there's nothing, you know, this is a quote, nothing you can do that can't be done. And there isn't anything that can be done that you can't do.
That's right.
So let's do it. You know, let's get it done. You know?
Yeah, we're here to help. We want to interview all of y'all. I want to take everybody, even if it's not about music.
Yeah,
if you're having problems and you experience, let's say that your best friend was murdered, since we deal with death and dying a lot in our work. Let's say that and you feel confident enough to talk about your pain and what you've been going through and sharing it to help others. We want to do that too. We would love to have y'all come and talk about something like that too.
Sure.
You know, or your family, or if you're pain, if you have pain you need to want to tell the world about. We'll sit in here, if you feel like filming that and being, wouldn't mind being on camera, we could do it that way. Of course, if you'd rather not be on camera, but we'll still help. But anyway, but that's the idea. We're going to get out, everybody going to start helping one another.
Yeah.
It's got to start that way. No more division. No more subdivisions. That song is a song by a band called Rush called Subdivisions.
Yeah.
About high school cliques and different cliques of people making fun of each other. And this clique of people, this clique, separation, subdivisions.
Right.
It doesn't work.
Yeah, I could never understand that kind of thing. I never understood in school why all everybody could get along, you know. Apparently, everybody else had it all figured out, but I didn't. I don't know why. I've never had a clique, but that's kind of how I feel now. I don't want to be in any clique. I want to be a part of unity, you know.
And support each other. Let me speak on this. Like, there was a comment, a guy, Vaughn. You know, this dude Vaughn, one of our people in here, does music. And Jay Vaughn, if you're listening, man, you know. I wrote the comment on your page about, he was talking about that he listens to the only music that comes from Richmond, local music. And then, but yet, a lot of people, I've seen people laugh at people who listen to local music in the car. They like make fun of them, and they're like, you're an idiot, you know, why are you listening to this? You're stupid, you know, this is garbage. Why are you going to want to listen to this shit? It's not, no one knows these people. These people are stupid. I've seen people say that, but I have local music in my car.
Yeah,
I have all kinds of stuff up there
on
the line, and I'll play it.
Oh, yeah. Growing up, it was like, you know, used to be a lot of rock groups in town and stuff I used to love, you know. I mean, and those guys could have gone somewhere further, and I know that they haven't.
Some of them have.
Some of them just didn't do anything. I've heard a lot about a lot of them, and some of them just went off, worked a job.
And then that was it.
That's it, you know.
The same thing happened in the rap scene and stuff, and too, the rock music scene, rap scene, and same thing is going on. Seems like there's more rap music in Richmond these days than there used to be.
I noticed that
a lot. It used to be all kind of heavy metal rock or punk rock music.
Yeah.
There was a ton of that local music back in the 90s, late 80s, but, you know, I remember it very clearly. But now it's turned into more of a rap scene, which is all right. It's all good.
Whatever. Yeah, yeah.
I like all kinds of stuff.
Whatever's on the rise, you know, whatever not on the rise, maybe we can help get it arose, you know, arisen.
That's right. That's what I wrote up, Rise Up.
Yeah.
I hear that song in my head, Rise Up.
Yeah.
You know, Raise, I think it's called Raise Up, Rise Up. It's something like... As you guys talk about North Carolina and Florida, it's a guy from North Carolina that did a rap song. Pete Pablo, that's who did it. that guy. I don't know, that song came to mind. Like, rise up, you know, north. I forgot how it went, but it just came to mind. But yeah, I wrote that in that message. You have to raise up Richmond, right? Raise up other people.
Yeah.
Raise up other people, and then you know, by virtue of your action raising others, you raise yourself. And before you know it, you be big. And psychically, I think I can tell, I mentioned this before, we're low on time, but we'll come back to it in the next video in a couple minutes. But psychically, I can tell you Richmond will blow up. And it will be a big music city, and it will be a well-known city for rap music, especially. And I can tell you that I see quite a few of you, you know, that are going to be shining stars in different ways. My word I use for it, y'all are going to be very, some of y'all are headed to very good spots.
Some of them just need a push.
Some of y'all aren't even aware of it yet that you're going to be there, but you will.
Yeah.
I see it all clear as day, and when I see this, it's usually very correct.
Like I said, I know a guy that can write, tells great stories, so I know they can write great stories,
But he just doesn't do it.
No, and
he's just embarrassed about it.
He needs that push, because if somebody would just give him the opportunity, for him to, if he was to let me read something, that if he wrote, he tells him stories that he's made up, he told him they're great, maybe it's just that push, he just needs a little push, hey, somebody else is doing it, okay, maybe I'll do it.
Sometimes it helps me when other people say, yeah, Matt, you did good in that,
because
I'm real humble, it's hard for me sometimes to accept, that stuff sounds good to others. Sometimes I'm critical of myself. Sometimes.
I understand the same thing.
Jeremy can be like that too.
I'm bashful as all can be when it comes to my own music sometimes. I don't want people to see my guitar playing. I don't want them to see my face. But my hair, apparently, as you see, I kind of hide behind my hat and my shades, But
that's,
I'd rather just be Jeremy, But,
keep on going.
I do the best I can, but the thing is, I also know it doesn't matter if I'm on top first or the next person's on top first. As long as that karma's going back and forth, everybody's helping each other out. Doesn't matter who's famous first, whatever. But let's get everybody on board.
That's the point.
It doesn't matter.
Where you're from, how old you are, how young you are,
how little you do.
Use your talent. You've been an artist, draw. If you love to draw, just keep drawing. Don't ever think that you're stuck in life and that your destiny is to be a nobody. Because it's not true. Everybody is somebody. Everybody's important to the universe, and all of you are important to us. We love all of you.
I think universally, when you have the talent that you don't use.
It's important that you wake up and use it.
It's the universe saying something to you right there. I'm giving you a gift. Use it.
And if you don't use it, you don't want to have to, we got another minute, you don't want to have to bounce back and live another physical life, This comes to a bigger thing, like with reincarnation, which is a fact, by the way. all of y'all might not remember your lives right now, some of your past lives, but believe me, they're there. You'll remember them when you cross over, but if you don't remember them earlier. But for the last minute, I'm going to talk about that. I'll sit behind the camera and watch the time. It's 19 minutes. But if you don't remember it now, you remember it when you die. But Jeremy and I are fortunate enough to be able to scan on through our past lives. We were able to see many of them. We haven't seen all of them, of course, but we've come across many of them. And our meditations, and we've been given a gift by the universe to be able to look at others' past lives sometimes. We can just look in people's eyes and see their past lives. We stare in your eyes for a few seconds. I see people's faces warp into who they were in other lives. I see it just turn one face to another. I can see what they look like and see what they are feeling. Sounds crazy, but it's the truth from the bottom of my heart. I see portals, I look at stuff, stare at the wall, I see a portal blow out of it, a doorway that you can go through. But 1950, we're going to let this go for now, and we're going to start part two in just a few seconds. Peace be with you.